examination of the antenatal mother during the period of antenatal. What is the purpose of antenatal examination?
To assess the
well-being of the baby as well as the well-being of the mother. To assess the
high risk
growth and development of the baby. And to assess the
high risk
pregnancy. And to manage the early complication of the pregnancy. And also helpful
To reduce the maternal mortality rate as well as the fetal mortality rate.
So antenatal examination has the four steps. One is the physical examination of the mothers, and another is the abdominal examination of the mother, and another the investigation such as the blood test हो गया, urine test, and आपका HB monitoring. So lot of blood test investigation can be carried out during the physical examination. So first we will apply this privacy to the patient. Our procedure will go into four principles. First is the preparation of the nurse, preparation of the articles, preparation of the client and unit, and step of the procedure, and termination of the articles, recording, reporting, and
health education.
So antenatal examination, first preparation of the nurse. Nurse should be prepared physically as well as the mental preparation. So in physically, hair should be tidy, dress should be neat and clean, nail should be cut short, sleeve should be above the elbow, and the shoes should be well covered. In next one is the preparation of the articles. Antenatal examination containing following tray. One is the HB estimation tray, which are used to measurement of the hemoglobin. Examination tray, it is used for examining the urine for sugar and albumin. And another tray is antenatal assessment, which contain BP monitoring instruments at the BP of test with stethoscope. One sheet which are used to maintain the privacy of the patient. One is the gloves which are used to prevention of the cross infection to patient to nurse and nurse to patient. One is the paper bag in which we will put the dry waste, and one is the sanitizer which are used to dry hand hygiene. And one is the this measuring tape which are used to measure the fundal height as well as the girth of the fundus. So this is about the instrument. And one is the weighing machine. It is used for measuring the weight when mother is coming here into the clinic. And there will be a steedometer which are used to measure the height of the mothers. Because all these instruments are used to diagnose the complication of the mother. For example, if mother is less than 45 cm, it indicates short structure and can be a CPD, spelopelvic disproportion. In weight, every time we will take the weight of the mother, it is useful to know the progress of the
fetus, progress
of the pregnancy, and increase the weight of the fetus as per their period of gestation. So today we will do only the abdominal examination of the antenatal mother. So first we will start. Here we will use the inspection. We will see the any scar, linea nigra, striae gravidum, any size of the abdomen. Is it pendulous or sausage? It all the observation can be done with the help of visualization with the eyes. So this is known as inspection. And next one is the abdominal examination. In that we will use the foregrip. And firstly, we will measure the height of the fundus. So before doing the abdominal examination, instruction should be given to the mother to empty their bladder, because it will interfere with the measurement of the fundal height. So first we will warm our hand. First we will clean our hand with the help of sanitizer. It is dry hand hygiene. So after that we will warm our hand with the help of friction, and we will put the hand over the mother abdomen and explain the procedure to the mother. And after that we will our face should be toward the head of the mother. Three grip, when you are using the three grip, in that our face will be toward the mother head. So first we will see the fundal height. We will check the fundal height with the help of that ulnar roller. So we will go like that. Where we will get the resistance, for example, here we will get the resistance. We will put the mark over here. So with the help, with the permission of the mother, we will take the permission for the mother. Can we put mark over here? Then we will put the mark here, and we will measure the fundal height from the pelvic rib. That symphysis pubis to the mean symphysis pubis, kahan hai hamari? Above the pelvic rib. So we will take the measurement from the symphysis pubis to the where we will get the resistance. So we will measure like this. So we will put the instep like that, and we will move the instep up to here. It show how much it was. It is 28 weeks because it is two finger above the umbilicus. So it show 28 weeks. It is adequate 28 weeks, which show 7 months. According to LMP, there will be 7 months. So our fundal height also correspondent to the period of gestation. So we will first we will see the fundal height, then we will see the abdominal girth. So we will put the instep behind the abdomen, and will this will take after 7th month. So we will take the girth of the fundus. It is 66. It will be increased at full term. It will be 100 centimeters. So this is the another examination, and then we will take the pelvic, yeah, we can say the
four manuals.
So first manual we will assess the fundal. We will see the part which is occupying in the fundus. So fetal part which is occupying in the fundus, we will check with the help of hand. So we will use the palm of the fingers, pad of the fingers, and the palm of the hand. We will not use the tip of the finger. So we will go at the level of umbilicus. Here we will go up like that in movement, and we will go up to the fundus like that, and we will see here what we will see here. If there is a presentation is sapelli, here we will say irregular, smooth, and broad mass, which indicate the presentation is sapelli. So after that we will take the second grip. Face should be up to the mother head. Here we will put the pressure of the palm. We will put the pressure over the fetus, and we will tilt the fetus one side, and we will check the part of the fetus and the back of the fetus with the help of hand. Similarly, we will do like that. It will show lie of the fetus. So where we will get the curvature, that indicate it is a spine, back of the fetus. So the third maneuver is we will see the pelvic grip. That is the, here we will see the, we will hold the head of the fetus with the help of fingers and thumb, and will grasp the head of the fetus. Here we feel hard globular mass. It is movable, which show descent is not occur here at present. If we will feel, if we will hold the head of the fetus, it will blot. It show there will be a no engagement. The fourth, in fourth grip, our face should be toward the woman face. Here we will go below the umbilicus to the like that, and here we will feed the fetal head. If our finger remain over the head, it is known as diversion. If our finger will go into the pelvic brim, it is known as conversion. So it show the descent of the fetus. These four maneuvers are used when we are doing the fundal examination of the antenatal mother. Next one is the auscultation. That will, in that we will assess the fetal heart sound. Here we feel the lie is left occipital interior. then we will listen the fetal heart sound below the umbilicus. It is 2.2 fingers away from the center of the umbilicus. Here we will see the fetal heart sound. So we will auscultate the normal fetal heart sound, is 140 to 160 beat per minute. With the help of stethoscope we can, or even we can listen the fetal heart sound with the help of fetoscope. So this is tell us about the heart rate of the fetus. So this is about the fundal abdominal examination of the antenatal mother.